cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Divine Touch International Ministry presents Pastor John Okene, a servant of God with integrity, anointed with the healing, deliverance, teaching, and preaching ministry. As you listen to this message, may you be positively impacted and empowered by the living word of God. Open up your heart and receive divine touch.
Can we lift your hands and appreciate him and give him praise? Bless his holy name. Give him praise, give adoration. In Jesus' name we pray. Lift your hands and give him praise. Appreciate him. Ekueme. You are the living God, oh. Is there no one like you? Ekueme. Ekueme. You are the living God, oh. Is there no one like you? You are my healer, my keeper, my restorer, my life giver. You are the living God, oh. Is there no one like you? No one can do me like you do. No one can touch me like you do. You are the living God, oh. Is there no one like you? Rock of ages, clear for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Rock of ages, clear for me. Let me hide myself in thee. You are my shield, you are my covering, you are my stability, are my foundation. You are my shield, you are my covering, you are my stability and my foundation. Take me to the place you are, the secret place. I say, that's where I want to be. I say, oh Lord, take me to the place. I say, the place you are. I say, the secret place. I say, that's where I wanna be. Oh, I say, that's where I wanna be. Take me to the place. To the place. I say, the place you are. Oh, the secret place. Oh, that's where I wanna be. I say, take me to the place. Oh, the place you are. I say, the secret place. I say, that's where I wanna be. I say, that's where I wanna be. Rock of ages, cleft for me. I say, let me hide myself in thee. Rock of ages, let for me. Oh, let me hide myself in thee. You are my shield, you are my covering, you are my star. say, that's where I want to be. Take me, Lord, take me to the place you are. Oh, the secret place, I say, that's where I want to be. Oh, that's where I want to be. Take me to the place, to the place I serve, the place you are. Oh Lord, the secret place, that's where I want to be. I serve, take me to the place you are, the secret place, that's where I want to be. I say, that's where I want to be. You got times and seasons in your hand. You call for light, not of darkness. You don't need a man to be the God you are. For you are choosing to call me own. You are God, you are God, from the beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. You are God,
you are God,
from the beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. And seasons in your hands. Oh Lord, you call for light out of darkness. Oh, you don't need a man to be the God you are. For you're chosen, for you are chosen. Oh, to call me own. Oh, you are God. There's no place or argument. Oh, you are God all by yourself. Oh, you are God.
You are God
from the beginning to the end. There's no place for argument. Oh,
you are God all by yourself.
Take the glory, Lord. Take the glory. My soul say yes, say yes to your will. Wherever you lead me, I will follow. Whenever you call me, I will answer. Oh, my Lord, please teach me how to know your way. Wherever you lead me, I will follow. Whenever you call me, I will answer. Oh, my Lord, please teach me how to know your way. Whatever it takes, whenever you want, one moment you choose, whatever your plan. Oh, my Lord, let your will be done in me. So be my light, be my guide, be my way, be my way. Oh, my Lord, please lay your hands all over me. So be my light, be my guide, be my will, be my will. Oh, my Lord, please lay your hands all over me. My soul say yes, I say yes, I say yes. Oh, my soul say yes, I say yes, oh, true. My soul say yes, I say yes, oh, say yes. I say my soul say yes, I say yes. My soul say yes, I say yes. Oh,
say yes.
Oh, my soul say yes, I say yes. My soul say yes,
my soul say yes,
I say yes, I say yes. My soul say yes, I say yes, I say truly. My soul say yes,
I
say
yes.
And give him praise and appreciate him. Thank him. Your life will not remain the same in this 2018. Give him praise. Give him adoration. We worship you. We adore your holy name. Be magnified. Be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we worship. Lift your hands. One prayer point you are going to pray. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father. As I begin to pray today, in the name of Jesus, as the oil will touch my head today, oh Lord, let my life be turned around 360 degrees for the positive, in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and talk to God. Let my life be turned around. Let there be a massive turnaround, 360 degree turnaround. Oh yes, lift up your voice and talk to God. Kabo Shita, Kabo Santaya. Let there be a turnaround, 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 turnaround. 360 degree. Open your mouth and talk to God. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Now pick your Bible quickly. We're going to be fast. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 1. I'm going to read just one of that verse. 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 1. Then Samuel took a vial of oil and poured it upon his head and kissed him and said, is it not because the Lord has anointed thee to be captain over his inheritance? Quickly, I'll be talking about the power behind the oil. The power behind the oil. The power behind the oil. Father, we want to thank you, bless your name. As we go into your word briefly, go with us. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Can I hear a loud amen to that? God bless, please can have your seat. I'm talking about briefly the power behind the oil. Many times, there are different types of oil, but specifically we're talking about an oil that is anointed. And there is a power behind the oil. And the power that is behind the oil is the Holy Spirit. The oil itself symbolizes, is an element that symbolizes the Holy Spirit, the presence of the Holy Spirit. There are some certain elements that you can use to symbolize the Holy Spirit. You can talk the element of fire as an element. You can talk about water. You can talk about the anointing oil, and you can talk about the animal in from the bed in form of dove that symbolizes it. Now, it symbolizes it, does not mean it is it. Can I talk to someone today? That means to say that there's a power that behind it. These are the symbols, okay, to show. So, most times, when the oil is placed on your life, you know, when you are anointed in a service like this, it's not just an ordinary oil. The oil becomes anointed based on who prays on it. Can I talk to someone here today? And I'm believing God today that as the oil comes upon someone here today, your life will never remain the same in the name of Jesus. As you say a better amen, may it come to pass in Jesus' name. We begin to look at the different uses of the oil. One of the things that we see about the anointing oil is that the oil is used as a soothing balm. A soothing balm. A soothing balm means he puts an end to pain. He puts an end to sorrow. It simply means that what happens for someone that is sick, the oil brings on the head, puts an end to sickness in the life of that person. We see in the book of James chapter 5 from verse 14 to 16, James 5, 14 to 16 quickly, the Bible begins to tell us, it says, if anyone is sick among you, let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with the oil in the name of the Lord. So it means that when the oil comes upon a man that is sick, I'm not just talking about the power behind the oil, is released, activated. And automatically, he puts an end to sickness. I want to congratulate someone here today. We might not pray long prayers today, but the oil is already anointed. The oil, there's a power behind it. As the oil will hit your head, anything that represents sickness in your life, in the name of Jesus, as you say amen, he will leave you by fire. I didn't hear a loud amen to that. Now, I didn't hear an amen that can bring testimony. Now, I didn't hear an amen that can bring total healing to somebody. It puts an end. You have heard testimonies now. Countless testimonies. At times, I don't even remember the testimonies again. Anytime I want to preach, I try to look at the testimony to pick. I'm confused. Because they are countless. Hello? From Thursday to Thursday, daily, the ones that call on the phone, the ones that come here, and if God is faithful, and there have been testimony of all kinds of healing, ranging from HIV, ranging from what happened, cancer, ranging from, you know, genotype changing, all kinds of healing. Hello?
So the oil brings it. That is why he said in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 8, verse 20. He said, the harvest is past. 2017 has passed. That's what he's saying. The summer is ended. Hello? And we are not saved. We are not healed. We are not delivered. Why? Then he says, for the heart of the daughter of the people, I am hot and I'm black. Astonished had taken hold on them. They are astonished. I said, what is happening? I thought that God is a healer. I thought that God is Jehovah Rapha. He's Jehovah Rapha. And God asked me a question. Son, in verse 20, is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no oil to anoint the people? Can't you take the oil and anoint them and decree in the name of the Lord that they be healed? He said, is there no physician there? Am I not the great physician? Why can't you show yourself to them? Why can't you show me to them? Why can't you introduce me to them and let them know that no matter their sickness, the great physician can put an end to their sickness? No matter the sickness you carry for years, no matter the doctor's report, the God we serve is a God that specializes in impossibility. He can turn the sickness around. He said, are there no physician? Why then is the health of the daughter of my people not recovered? Why are you still sick? Why is that sickness in your body? Said the Lord, thus said the Lord. Today, I've come to introduce to you the power behind the oil is a member of the Trinity, the Holy Spirit. Okay? And he has come to glorify Jesus Christ. Because the Bible said, Jesus said, he said, the Holy Spirit will come. He will not do anything of his own. He will do everything he's instructed, and is to glorify me. That is what the Holy Spirit has come to do. Today, as the oil touches you, the Holy Spirit, the power behind the Holy Spirit, will be activated in your life, and Jesus will be glorified. Sickness does not glorify Jesus. I prophesy, whatever that represents sickness in your life, if you say better amen, is leaving you in a hurry. It's leaving in a hurry. It's leaving in a hurry. If you say better amen, you are just got healed before the oil touches you now. So we see that there, and then we also see in Luke chapter 10, verse 33 to 34, we see the case of the Samaritan that came in and saw someone that is wounded and took the person to him. And in verse 34 of that scripture, the Bible said, and he went to him and bound up his wound and poured oil on the wound. You might be here today and say, man, say, well, pastor, I'm not sick. But it's like I've been disappointed. Pastor, I've been wounded. Oh, so many things. You are going through what we call emotional hurt. You have been wounded emotionally and you need healing. You need that, what happened, emotional healing. I came to announce to you, this same oil, as it touches you, every emotional wound you had, today you get your healing in Jesus' name. You will get your healing in Jesus' name. Now, can I hear a resounding amen? Can I hear an amen that can bring testimony? The second thing we see about the oil is a lubricant. It means it lubricates. Have you ever come in contact with a door? A rusted door. You try to open it, it's making us crum, crum, crum. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about. Or you have discovered you have, like, you know, the burglary, you know, the rolling burglary in my house. You know, you try to roll it, it's tips. So what would you do? You just say, okay, now take oil. So they, as they put the oil in it and they do it like this, it begins to swing. Hello? Am I talking to someone today? Now, many of you have been struggling in life. You put in so much effort, but you get the maximum result. Why? Because whatever you are doing is not oil. Listen to me. When the oil comes upon your life, he makes life easy for you. Hello? He puts an end to your labor. He puts an end to your struggle. There was a man called in Acts chapter 2, verse 40 to 41, a man called Peter. Peter was a man that was struggling. When Jesus called him, he was struggling to live a holy life. He got to a stand that while he said, no, Jesus, I will not deny you, I won't deny you. Before Jesus died, and they captured Jesus. He followed you, I'll follow you. By the time I got there, he got to the place and then someone said, hello, this guy, I know this person, this is one of the disciples. He said, me? You don't understand. I swear, from my father that come from Agbaru. Now lie. You don't know, I don't ever see him before. This man, we are, I don't ever see him. So, then they called Jesus. He denied him. They asked him again, look, my mother that came from Ijebu, I swear without, I've not even heard of him. He denied Jesus. The Bible says, deny Jesus thrice. It's because the oil has not been released. And Jesus appeared. When Jesus died, Peter went forth and went back. He said, look, all of them, look. This ministry, I don't understand that thing. Jesus, don't go. So let me go back. Hello? And Jesus was to go and meet the Father, to sit at the right time of the Father. And if I said, listen to me. You cannot go and sit where the people on earth is not standing. There must be someone that is standing before you go and sit. So you are not going anywhere. Stay on earth and make sure they stand before you sit, because where they are not standing, you cannot sit. And so he ran, came back, and met Peter fishing. The man leave everything. He was busy fishing. Look, I'm going to fishing. And just appeared and said, he said, Peter, after the other, he said, Peter, thou lovest me more than this. This your business, this your work you are doing, you love me past this work. Do you know your priority at all? I know you love this your business, but must you love the business more than me? He said, God, you know I love you. He said, feed my sheep. He asked him again, 3 times he asked him. He said, Lord, you know all things. He said, listen to me. When you are a young man, you don't need any man to take you. But when you are old, you need someone to hold your hands. Now, some said the Bible talks about his death. But I read a more meaning to it. He said, when you are a young Christian, you can be doing anyhow. But listen to me. By the time you get matured, you are controlled by the Holy Spirit. The Bible says, listen to me, as many that are led by the Spirit of God, they are sons. There's a difference between a child and a difference between a son. And then there is a what? There is a man of God. Can I talk to someone here today? So by the time you get mature as a son, you cannot do anyhow. They will hold your hand. Anywhere they say go, you go. Hello? And they say, listen to me. Go to the upper room, tarry in Jerusalem until the power behind the oil appears in the scene. 120 of them, they were in the upper room and they were waiting. That is why we have come to wait in this season. But tomorrow we are waiting. They were crying. We need signs and wonders. We need a change. We need something. The Holy Spirit, the promise. And suddenly in Acts chapter 2, suddenly like a mighty rushing wind, he came with the elements. came in form of fire. He came in form of wind. He came in form of earthquake. That's a three-dimension anointing. Elijah got only the dimension of fire. But the apostle got the fire of the dimension of what? Of the wind and the fire. That's why the Bible said that anyone that is born again is like a wind. The wind blow it. Hello? Where? You don't understand where it's coming. Wind is different from air. Wind is a higher level of air. Can I talk to someone here today? When, listen to me, when a wind is about to blow, in some certain cases, airport closed down. I'm not sure if you know what I'm talking about. They said this one is Hurricane Ike, Hurricane Katrine, Hurricane this, where everything closed down. God is saying to someone here today, he said there are some satanic institution that because of you, after this oil that comes on your head, that they will close down. When they hear you are coming, they will be packing up. If you say better amen, it will come to pass. I said, we come to pass. I said, we come to pass. I say it will come to pass. Fume, the wind came. And the Bible said, what happened? That suddenly from nowhere, this guy's an hurricane now. He got up. This was a man that was denying Jesus Christ. And he preached. The Bible said, for the first time in the book of Acts, chapter 2, verse 40 to 41. Precisely 41, the Bible said that 3,000 souls were added to the church. He commanded results. I pray for you today. You have been struggling since, but result is coming your way. As the oil comes to your head, all your struggle comes to an end. He terminates struggle in your life. You are going to another dimension. If you say better amen, may the oil comes upon your head. Enough of struggling. Can I talk to someone here today? Look at the door. The door, just put the oil here. The door will just be swinging. So, your struggle, no matter what they throw at you to make you struggle, once the oil comes, those things will maintain. They know level. Can I talk to someone today? I pray for you today. Your struggle has come to an end. I say your struggle has come to an end. Now can I hear a loud amen to that? Now quickly, number three. Number three. Now the oil brings about enthronement. Enthronement. You are enthroned. You are promoted. You are lifted up. You look at the scripture. If you look at the case again, in this case of David, anytime David, his to what happened, was anointed before he became a king, they anointed him. So as the oil comes, the spirit of God came upon him. The spirit that comes is the spirit of enthronement that lifts you up. Hello? God said to Aaron, he said, before Aaron is what happened made, they should anoint him. So the priest or the prophet is anointed first. Hello? And the king is anointed. Now, he's anointed. The anointing brings about empowerment. It's not to say, man, I am anointed. No, you are not. It brings about empowerment. What is the empowerment? Number one, the Bible said, don't forget, you are a king. You can be a king and yet don't have power. Hello? But the anointing makes you be to be a king, not by mouth, but in deed. And one of the things you see about the king is his words. The Bible says that in Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 4, Ecclesiastes 8 4, it says, where the word of the king is, there is power. Power. It's a good inside, they obey. Hello? And look at what the Bible says to someone here today. It says, as the oil touches your head. In Job chapter 22 verse 28, in Job 22, it says, thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon the ways. Now go to 29. He said, when men say there is a cast down, then thou shalt say there is a lifted up, and it shall save the humble person. So he said, you now begin to operate by decree. Someone this time, you will get to a place that things are not working. Come. He said, my friend, you know who is talking here. A king has come. You, this thing is not working. In the name of Jesus, begin to walk now. He has no choice. Can I tell you? You know, in school, they tell us only the living things can hear. True of us. But in the spirit realm, everything hears and everything speaks. God said to the earth, O earth, hear the word of God. The earth, the ear. Do you know that the whole thing speaks? Go to Psalm 19 for me, verse 1. Psalm 19, verse 1. Quick. He said, the heavens declare the glory of God. Did he talk? The firmament showeth his handwork. Go for that. Day unto the utter speech, night unto night, and night unto night showeth knowledge. He said, day unto day, the firmament, the heavens, they're speaking. They're speaking. They speak. Look at what it says. He said, there is no speech or language where their voice is not heard. You go hear them. So, there's a way you are empowered. You speak to the earth. All you earth, you are not supposed to be eating the fruit of my labor. What did they worry you? So when they speak to it again, it says, hey, it speaks back to them. Say, you know why here say king dot decree? King dot decree. He said this year they're not going to be dead. So I'm not permitted to swallow anybody in this family. But in case you want me to swallow something, I can swallow the person. So when they go to the ground, somebody say, oh, you ground, I speak to, as long as this family must match the earth, I decree that there will be death every year in this family. And so they become dead. But you now, you get the oil and you are enthroned. You say, you speak and talk to the earth. Lay your hands on it and say, oh, yet. Yeah, word. Yeah. You know, yes, you. A king has come. I'm living by decree. Now, starting from now, you are not permitted to swallow anybody in this family again. So I close you. Now, when they see nothing happens, they go back to the head and say, oh, earth. You know, here, we don't sacrifice. I will not tell you, say, you will open mouth and swallow them. Why you don't swallow them? And the earth will speak back to them and say, listen to me. The king came and made a decree. He said, no more will he collect. So I don't have the power to open. But just in case you want me to swallow something, I can start with you and your family. I pray for you today. Starting from now, all those that don't want you to shine, may the head fight against them. I decree now as a king, may the head begin to fight against them. May the head fight against them. If your amen is the loudest, you are here for testimony.
We believe you've been richly blessed and inspired by the living word of God, delivered by Pastor John Okene. We invite you to worship with us live at Divine Church International Ministries, where the anointed servant of God, Pastor John Okene, will be teaching and preaching the undiluted word of God with signs and wonders. Worship with us this Sunday. First service, 8 a.m. to 9:30 a.m. Second service, 9:30 a.m. to 11 a.m. What's more, join us every Thursday for our interdenominational power-packed Divine Church program, which takes place by 10:30 a.m. It's one meeting you can't afford to miss. Venue, Divine Church International Ministries, situated at Paradise Hall, Mosheshe Estate, off Airport Road, Efun, Delta State, Nigeria. For prayers and counseling, reach us on 081-359-526-23. 081-359-526-23. God bless you.